Hello and welcome to the Cheeky Homemaker, where we cook, clean, stay on budget, and journey through motherhood together. My name's Morgan. Today we're going to be talking about budgeting on an irregular income. So budgeting can be hard enough as it is, but budgeting on an irregular income can have a whole new set of challenges. If you missed my video on how to create a budget, make sure you check it out. I'll link it for you guys. Once you've established your expenses for setting up a budget, but then your income goes high and low, feast and famine, it can seem almost impossible to make everything match up. I have a great system in place for you guys, so I'm going to show you how to do that. And make sure you stay tuned until the end of the video, because I'm going to share with you what to do when you have excess money at the end of the week and how to make that money work for you. The first thing you need to do to set up a budget of any kind is figure out where your money's going and what your expenses are. I just finished a video all about setting up your expenses, so make sure you go check that video out after you're done watching this one, and that'll give you all the information and tips you need to figure out exactly what expenses you have every month. When you have an irregular income, you'll need to go a step further and prioritize all of those expenses. So your first priority might be your rent or mortgage payment. Your second may be your car payment. Your third may be your homeowner's insurance, and go from there. So once you have that list of expenses, go through, put them in order of priorities to you. Now, the first category in general to me should be things that will affect your credit if you're late on them, or where you'll actually lose something of importance to you. So a mortgage payment, a car payment, insurance payments, because we don't want to default on those. Credit card payments. We certainly don't want to mess our credit up by being late on expenses. And then we'll go into necessities as the next category. So necessities are probably going to include your utility bills, water, power, gas. Those are things that you can be late for quite a while before it affects your credit. But if you are late too much, you will get shut off. And once you start being late on things and giving yourself permission to do that, you start bad habits, you accumulate debt with them, even if they do or don't charge you fees for it. It's just a bad thing to do. So I think the next category should be the basic necessities of things that you can't or won't cancel if you find they're becoming too expensive. And then just go from there. You might find that to you, dining out once a week is really important, because that's your bonding time with somebody in your family or all of your family members. And you might even prioritize that over something like your television service. And if that's the case, let that be reflected in your order. Or you might find that there's something that maybe shouldn't, quote unquote, be more important than your grocery budget, but to you it actually is. Well, that's fine. Sometimes with our groceries, if we don't have quite enough money for our standard grocery budget, we've got a ton of stuff in our pantry and our freezer that we can cook. It's not like we're going to go hungry. So make sure that instead of looking at this as how you think it should be, you are very honest with yourself. The tool that I've set up for you to budget on an irregular income is what I call the budget thermometer. So if you have seen a fundraiser before for a school or some sort of nonprofit organization, sometimes they will make on a poster board, they'll have a big chart and it'll have a picture of a thermometer, and on that thermometer, it'll have different dollar amounts. And as they raise money towards their goal, they will color the thermometer in for the different dollar amounts, and it'll show on there that once they hit this amount, this mini goal is met, and et cetera, till they reach the top goal and this amount is met. Anyhow, that is the inspiration for my budget thermometer for you guys. So I have a free printable offered to you guys on my blog, thecheekyhomemaker.com. I've provided you with multiple versions of the budget thermometer because we all have different budgets. So you're going to want to look for the one that's just a few hundred dollars above however much your weekly expenses total. And I'll show you why in just a minute. This is what the thermometer looks like, and this one I've already filled out based on the example that I gave in my other video about how to make a budget. So this is the budget that we went off of in that video. It is completely fake, but it is, you know, it has categories that are very aligned with real life here. And the weekly expenses for this budget are $1,733. So I chose the budget thermometer that's the $2,000 budget thermometer. And next, you look at how you've prioritized everything. So for me, the first priority was the rent or mortgage. And the breakdown for rent or mortgage was $800 a week. So the first thing I did was right here where it says $800, I put rent, $800. Now, the next item you're going to put on here is going to be your second item in priority. And for me, that was car payment. So you need to look at how much your car payment costs. That on, for this example, it's $117.50 per week. So you're going to add, this is basically a running total. So you're going to add the $117.50 to the $800, because we, our rent was $800 and the car payment's $117.50, and that gives us $917.50. So just around the $900 mark on the thermometer, I wrote car payment, and I, instead of writing $117.50, I wrote $917.50, because that's how much money I need to be able to make that car payment and everything below it. So the next item was the Visa credit card payment, and it's up to you if you've worked out that you're making the minimum payment or a little bit over the minimum payment, which is much better if possible. And that running total becomes $946.25 because the Visa payment works out to $28.75 per week. So as you can see, I just took each item and I added the weekly amount of it to my running total, and I went up my budget thermometer. And some places I had to double up on the lines where I had smaller expenses. Other places I was skipping some lines here. So you just want to try to make sure as best you can the amount that you're writing in totals how much you're looking at as you go up the thermometer. Now, once you are bringing income in that week, you are going to use a highlighter to color up the thermometer. So if you bring income in small increments throughout the week, you can slowly add to it. If you get a weekly paycheck that's just very irregular, you can just color that in to begin with. So for an example, I'm going to say that this week we only brought in $1,500. So I would basically take my Sharpie, I'm sorry, not my Sharpie, my highlighter, and color all the way up to 1,500. For argument's sake, let's just say it's 1,500 even, because that makes it easier for my demo here. So I've colored in up to $1,500. There's still expenses above that. So that means that this week we can't afford anything that's above $1,500 because we didn't bring in enough money. So that means that our home supplies, which that's our category that covers toilet paper and home decor, whatnot, that's out. We don't have any extra money to set aside for savings. We don't have money for our IRA retirement contribution. Dining out as a family is not affordable. Mad money or allowance money for the husband and wife is not affordable. And TV service is not affordable. TV service is of the lowest priority to me on this fictitious budget sheet. So if you find that something like TV service, which is something you need to sign up for regularly, is constantly out of your budgeting range, you need to go ahead and cancel it. If it's something that you can either give or take, you know, do or not do on any given week, such as dining out as a family or setting aside money for savings or a retirement plan contribution, then that's fine. You just don't do it that week, but you do do it the next week. Now, if you're finding that every single week on average, there's things you simply cannot afford, but they are important to you, you should go back and look at your expenses that are in the lower categories and see if there's anywhere that you can kind of cut back so that you can make it to the amount you need to cover the expenses towards the top of the thermometer, or you may want to reprioritize. Now, the other side that comes with this is what about when you have a feast week, feast or famine, a feast week? Well, what you don't want to do is take that money and think, oh, we've got a little breathing room this week. Let's go out to a fancy dinner and go out to the movies. And, you know, maybe we'll go out and buy that couple hundred dollar purchase we've been putting off. That's really not a great idea, because the following week or 3 weeks from then, 6 weeks from then, you might find that you have a week where you don't even bring in enough money to cover gas for your cars. So what I recommend you doing in that situation is rolling the money over. And that comes to the tip that I promised you at the beginning of the video. If you do find you have extra money, even if it's a lot of extra money, I highly recommend that you do not start spending as if you have extra money. Because when you have an irregular income, just as often as you have extra money, you most likely will have not quite enough money. So you really want to let that money ride in the bank account and pretend it is not there. If you have to transfer it into a savings account to do so, by all means do that. Just make sure that you've notated somewhere what amount in your savings account is actually spending money, bills money, so that you don't accidentally dip into your real savings, or so that you don't accidentally forget it's there and never use it. But really, don't go overspending just because you feel a little breathing room, because you will be needing that money at some point. I hope that this helps you. I came up with it when I was budgeting off of an irregular income on a regular basis. So I know it really can work. It really did work for me, and it helped us get out of some debt that we had been accumulating up until I came up with this system. Make sure you check out my blog for more details on this topic and all the other topics I go over. It's www.thecheekyhomemaker.com. You can also find me on Facebook, Instagram, and Pinterest at The Cheeky Homemaker. Please give me a like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video. I am doing a full series on budgeting because I'm breaking up the very daunting and large topic into a series of videos. So if you hit subscribe, you'll be sure never to miss one of those. Thanks for watching. Hope to see you soon. Bye.